Hi, in this next video, the next step I want to show you guys is how to place your crouquis, your fashion flat template, into Illustrator, get it locked, get a new layer on top, and ready to go so we can start drawing our fashion flats. So we'll be working with the pen tool a little bit of the pencil tool for a couple of things, and as well as kind of just showing you some of the shortcuts for those of you who are very new to Illustrator. So here we go. I have a crouquis up and ready to place. So we'd already talked about artboards, and this is the artboard, and you've seen how to add more if you want them and all that. So we're back down to one artboard. I'm going to place the crouquis in. So what we do is in Illustrator, if you go to File, we're going to place it. Don't open it and put it in, but I want you to place it. So here we go. Let me find this guy. Flat template. And so if you notice down here, these are your options. If you don't read it, and let's say you just kind of hit place and it goes in. So let's just do that, place. And here it is. And so you click and it goes in, and you can move it and get it where you want. Well, what you notice over here, well, most importantly too, we'll talk about this as well. It's a linked file, meaning that it's not part of the document. It's linked to a file on your computer. So if you want it to be part of your document, then you can embed it. It does make for a larger file. But what we're going to do is, let's say this is what you did and you put your artboard. Well, the first thing you're going to need to do, and it's a mistake that is so common, you know, we put our crouquis in and we immediately grab the pen tool and we start drawing, and you're doing this and starting to do it, and then you realize halfway through you've actually been drawing on your crouquis itself. So to stop that from happening, and we're still on the artboard tab, so let's go back to layers. To stop that happening, we need to lock this layer. But before we do, a lot of times, now I made this template green and then I have violet style lines going through it because it's helpful when you're drawing with black that you can actually see. But if you would like to dim this and make it a little lighter so you can see your own pen strokes a little better, if you double click on this, this will actually pop up. And what you can do is you can click dim images to 50%. That's the default. If you don't want to dim it to 50 and you want to dim it to 75, or if you want to dim it to 80, go for it. Whatever you feel is best for you when you're drawing. So if you dim image, I'm just going to keep it at 50. And notice how it's dimmed. What I'm going to do is lock it, because when you lock it, when I try, it will not let me draw on this at all, which is a great thing, because sometimes I get going and it's best that I am locked and on another layer. And I don't realize, like I said, sometimes down the road, it's like, oh, I was drawing on the wrong layer. So then what you would do is down here, this is how you create new layers. And so I would create a new one. It would go on top. And then I would label this, let's say, bodice. Let's see. And hit that. And now I'm ready to go. But let's unlock this. Let me take this. Let me get rid of this layer. And we take this. Sorry. Delete it. We're back to this. Now what I'm going to do is something, is we're going to go back and we're going to place again. So now looking down here, I'm going to grab flat template again. I am going to check template and unlink the document. So it will become part of the document, and I'm going to place it. It automatically puts it in. Here it is. I already have a layer. There is no way I can mess this up. Well, I mean, there is a way later I can mess it up for sure, but there is no way at this point could I draw on my template. So you're ready to go. So this is a way to set it up. If you unlock this, you can do that by clicking right there and then double click here. You'll see it also goes ahead and it sets it up for you at 50%. So the computer does it all. And we come back. When you click here, you can lock and unlock layers. And so here we go. So I'm going to go back to this layer and I'm going to name it bodice, and do this. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go grab the pen tool, which is over here, or I'm going to hit P. Remember, P is the shortcut for pen tool, and we talked about this in class, so now I want to go over this again just with you quickly, kind of what's going on up here. This is a fill, so if I were to draw with the rectangle tool, And let me do a fill we could actually see besides white. Let me grab a gray. And I come here and I use the rectangle tool. You're going to see that that is the fill inside. This is the stroke, which is the outside here. So if you select this, and if I were to change the color of the stroke, then come over here, you can see, so the stroke will go around as well. Also too, let's go back to black. And now here I can actually change my stroke weight. So you can make it a little thicker if you would want, thinner. You can go to 0.25, and as you can see, Illustrator will not let you do anything until you select. So it's ever so delicate, but if we zoom in, we can see it. Using the zoom tool, which is right here, or Z, if you hit Z on your keyboard, this will pop up, and then just kind of draw a box over what you want to zoom in. And you can see now that we have a real delicate 2.25 point line around this. I'm going to hit V. Remember, V is the shortcut to take us back to our selection tool. So this is our selection, and this is our direct selection. And I'll talk a little more about the direct selection in a little bit, but selection is what you need to be on to obviously select anything for Illustrator. But please know that you are not held to these numbers. If you wanted to take this down to 0.12, you can type it in, and the computer will then put what you want. So these are just some of the ones the computer gives you, but please be aware that you can go in 2.5 or whatever you might like to do. The next thing, I'm gonna hit select, that I'd like to show you is uniform. Here, if you drop down, you have these wonderful, wonderful width profiles. This one, as you can see, takes this and changes the width this way. Now this is on a box, so the computer's going to do this. And once again, I need to select, don't I? And I'm gonna go here and I can play around with this one. But this itself works better when, let me show you with a pen stroke. So I'm gonna go back to uniform and I'm going to use my hand over here and I'm gonna pan over. And to do that quickly, just hit the space bar. When you hit the space bar on your computer and then just click and drag, it'll move. So what I'm going to do is grab my pen tool with P. I'm going to draw a line and hit V to get out of that. And what I want to show you is you can do this. So we've already seen with that, so both ends there. And so just take a look and see what the computer does. This one you're going to see, this one a little more pointed. This one we'll use often when we're doing drapes and things like that on fabric. So please don't forget that those are in here if you need them and you don't always have to stay with uniform. The next thing I'd like to show you is that as we're working, the stroke palette is here. There's also a stroke palette over here. So I'm gonna click on the one here. You start to see that there's caps and there's corners. What I like to do is right now, as you can see, it's a cap. I like to round cap. And if you see, as I click over here, it's rounded the edges of this. The reason I like to do that is because we are drawing fabric and fabric is soft. And you're going to find that sometimes when you draw this and you keep a hard edge, so if you keep a butt cap on the edge of it, sometimes you can get these sharp shards that tend to shoot off. And if you do get those, this is why it's happening. And it's a real easy fix. You just select all your lines and go back here and do this to begin with. I also want to go ahead and I'm going to do a round join. So if I were to add another line here, then I would have, the corners would be rounded as well. So everything would be soft. So fabric is soft, it just makes sense. So I'm going to set that up that way. So just a couple of little things to go over before we start. The next thing I'm going to do is, if you hit Command 0, and please remember, once again, I'm on a Mac. So when I say Command and you're on a PC, hit Control. Command 0 will bring us back to the full size of the artboard on the screen. Not necessarily image, but the artboard. We are now going to begin drawing a technical flat for fashion. So I'm going to get ready, and I'm going to change my fill back to white. It's hard sometimes to tell that if there is a fill because we do work on a white artboard. Maybe in a later video I'll show you how to change the color of the artboard, but it's not that big of a deal. I mean, you can also work with a really light gray, and that would let you know that you are, if your closed objects are closed or not. But, you know, the industry tends to want to have white fills when you're doing basic flats. And then obviously, if you're adding the fabric that the garment's going to be made of, then you would put your prints and your fabrics and your fabric colors in. But we're just going to start with white, okay? So be very aware as we go through this when I ask you to have something filled and when I ask you to not. To not have a fill and to just have a stroke, you go to where this red line is and it says none. And so you can go back and forth that way. I'm going to hit V, go over here, and you can see that if I'm, watch up here, the shortcut to take the fill off is very easy. If you hit the backslash key on your keyboard, watch what happens right here. I'm just going to hit backslash, and what it'll do is it'll turn my fill off. So now I have none, but I do want a fill, so I'm going to go ahead and do white. I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to grab my Z. I'm going to come in just like this because I can. And I want to be able to see what I'm doing. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to grab my pen tool, which is a P. I'm going to make sure that I have a black stroke, a white fill, and I want my stroke weight to be 1 point as I start this. Now, this depends on the garment that you're drawing, where you're going to start this. I mean, some t-shirts come right here, and that's at the high point shoulder. We talked about this, and we'll use this often in measuring and making technical packages, and this is low point shoulder. But, you know, often shirts don't come right up to here, so you need to look at your garment and decide, or your own design, and decide where it sits on the shoulder between the high point and the low point. So I'm going to start mine right around here. So right off on top of the shoulder, I'm going to go here and here, and then I'm going to click right under the arm, right where it's across the chest, across the apex of the breast. I'm going to click and hold and drag. What that does is it allows me to actually make the beginnings of the armhole. Now, what's going to happen is you can see, if I were to continue and click one more time, I'm going to get, right at the circus, right? I'm going to get, a line that's going to give me a curve. And now I don't want that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click once on this anchor point and notice how the bottom handle, we have two handles, which allows us to kind of play with the shape and the curves. I'm going to click once here. And when I do, you notice that that handle has gone away. So now what I'm going to do is kind of come back here and finish off this side of the shirt. And then I'm going to hit V, which will take us to selection, and it's selected and I've clicked away. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a tool. It is buried over here, and oops, sorry about that. It's in the pin tool, and it's the anchor point tool. And Shift C, as you can see, is the shortcut for that. So I'm going to pull this anchor point tool, but it is not only just for anchor points. What it does now is it allows you to go into a line, and you can take this and move it in. So I'm going to move the waist in just a little on this garment. Please also realize, unless this t-shirt is painted onto the body, it's going to come off of the body. The t-shirt I'm wearing right now is a little oversized and it hangs off my body, so it's not going to be just painted around the side. So keep that in mind as you design these and as you create your technical drawings. So like I said, I'm gonna go back to V and select it. Now what I'm gonna do is, I'm not gonna draw that again. Why would I? I'm going to reflect it. So if you come over here and you see that this is the rotate tool. And also, if you see little arrows on the sides of these, there's great stuff buried in there. So I'm gonna click and hold, and what's buried in here is the reflect tool. And what you're also gonna see is the letter O, not the number zero, but the letter O is the shortcut for that. I will be using the letter O for the rest of the time when I do the demos, but just to let you know where it is, when you do this, you're going to see that this icon pops up right here. What I need to do is move this to tell the computer exactly where I want it to reflect from. Well, since this is a symmetrical garment, what I need to do is reflect it from the center body. So I'm going to hold the Alt key, and then I'm going to click somewhere on the center line. It doesn't matter where, as long as it's on the center line, I'm going to click. This menu is going to pop up, and it's a reflect menu. Here's vertical. Make certain it's on vertical. Do not hit OK. Hit copy. If you hit OK, it's going to take this one and just move it over here. But if you hit copy, it's going to copy that one and bring it to the other side. So here we go. Now we have both of them. I'm going to hit V, which is selection, and then draw a little marquee around them with the direct or with the selection tool. As long as it touches both of them somewhere, they'll both be selected. And then I'm going to right-click Join, and then right-click Join again. Now what I'm going to do is hit Shift-C, which takes us back to that anchor point tool, remember, and the computer's going to tell me, bam, when I hit them inside. Now I'm going to drop down and make the neck. Same thing, computer's going to tell me when I've hit the center, and I'm going to do the bottom drop of the shirt. So we have the basic shape of the bodice of this t-shirt that we're making. So now what I'm going to do is we need sleeves. So what I'm going to do is show you how to use the Shape Builder tool. It's a pretty awesome thing. You know, once it came out, my whole Illustrator world changed for the better, obviously. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start the sleeve over here and make certain that you begin on the anchor point so you have a connection. I'm going to pull the sleeve down here and then back and make certain that it goes into the anchor point here. Computer lets you know when you do it. I'm going to hit V for selection, and you're going to see, I'm going to zoom in, and another way to zoom in is the command plus sign. Then I'm going to hold the space bar and I'm going to pan in. As you can see, it's not completely filled because this is not a closed object. As you can see, I only have three sides to this object. What I'm about to do is use the Shape Builder tool and ask the computer to share this line with this part of the t-shirt as well as the sleeve. So that means with my selection tool selected, I need to make certain that I touch both sides of this when I select them. Now I'm going to hit Shift M, and this is the Shape Builder tool that you'll find right over here in the menu. Shift M is a shortcut, so you can see all these things happening here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click, hold, and then drag, and now I've made the shape. So you can see that these are now two different shapes happening here. Also too, there's the shards I was talking about. So let's round the cap and round the corner. So look how they just disappeared, and glad that happened. So now you really can see the difference and why it's important to round your caps and corners. So I'm gonna zoom out a little. And now that I've got this done, what I'm gonna do is reflect this sleeve over here. But before I do that, I want to take care of any stitching or anything like that that would be happening on this sleeve. This sleeve has a double needle cover stitch on it. So what I need to do is draw this. So I'm going to zoom in. And what I like to do with my stitches is I'm going to lock the bodice. I'm going to add a new layer and I'm going to call it Stitches and Details. This is where, when I hit my pen tool, the first thing I want to do now is get rid of the fill. I don't want to fill. I'm drawing a line. I'm drawing what is going to be the stitches on a garment. So I'm going to hit the backslash, and you'll notice it goes away. I'm going to grab the pen tool, and I'm going to draw a line from here to here. Trying to do the same angle as that. I'm going to hit V and select it. And I'm going to change the points to 0.5. Now what I'm going to do is take this and then copy, paste in front, which is Command F. So another line goes right on top of it. Then I'm going to use my arrows and get those the way I want them. Now what I'm going to do is, they aren't stitches yet, so I'm going to select both of them. So there's two ways to select both of these. You can take your marquee, draw a little marquee with your selection over both, and they're both selected. Or you can click on one, hold the Shift key, and click on another, and holding the Shift key allows you to select as many things as you need to. Either way, what I'm going to do now is group them together. I'm not joining them, I'm grouping them. So when I move them, or if I do anything else, they're together now. They're something that I can deal with once and not separately. So I'm going to hit Object, Group, or you can right-click and group as well. Now I'm going to go back to our stroke palette, and I need to make these look like stitches, which is easily done. In Illustrator, I'm going to click on Dash Line, and I'm going to change this 12 point to 1. I'm going to change the gap to 1. And now I have what looks like a set of stitches. Now at this point you can decide if 0.25 is too thick. It might be. This is also where, like, okay, it's like, maybe I want to space these together, but they're grouped and I just want to move this top one. You can work in isolation mode, which means I select it, they're grouped, so they both get selected. Keep clicking on the one that you want to work with until everything else kind of ghosts away and you have what you're looking for. And then now you can move that one a little closer. And then to get out of isolation mode, just keep clicking and double clicking off on the side. And now we have our stitches. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my sleeve. I will need to unlock it. So I'm going to come down here, grab my sleeve, and then also grab my stitches. So I'm going to select those. I'm going to hold the shift key and select both of them. Now what I'm going to do is go to my bodice layer, and I'm going to hit the letter O. Here's that icon, right? I'm going to hold the Alt key. Click on that center path. This pops up. Make certain it's vertical. Hit copy. Now I'm going to zoom out. And it brought that sleeve over to the other side. So now I have the sleeve on both sides, and I'm ready to go. The next thing we have to do is the back of the neck of the t-shirt. So if it were lying flat, you would see the back of the fabric because the front scoop of the neck is lower than the back. So there are a couple ways to do this. Once again, the Shape Builder tool is awesome. You know, we can take this and anchor point here, hold or go to Shift C, pull this down. Now back to selection by hitting V. I'm gonna draw a box over both of these lines, the scoop of the neck and the back, to select them both. They're both selected. Now I'm gonna hit Shift M, which is once again that Shape Builder tool. I'm gonna click right in the middle, and then this ended up popping up, so hold the Alt key and you'll see how a minus sign, and then you click again and that part goes away. Now I have this, and this is its own object. So I can fill this in with a little darker gray so you can see that this is the back of the garment or the t-shirt, and so now we have that. If for some reason you can't get the Shape Builder tool to work for you, or I don't know why that would be, but you know, old school, the way we used to do it, let me move this guy over here, is I would go and grab my rectangle tool, grab a rectangle here and here, do something like this. Once again, now I can do Shift C. I don't have to add an anchor point to do anything, and I don't have to deal with the anchor point tool. I can just bring down the back of the neck this way, hit V to select it, then right click, arrange, and then I'm going to send it to the back. And what's happening is it's not sending it to the back because I'm on the stitches layer. So let me lock that, stay on the bodice layer. And what I did do, and I'm kind of glad I did this because I was just talking while I was doing this and wasn't paying any attention. So what we need to do is when we draw this square or a rectangle, we need to make certain, so let's lock the stitches, that we're on the bodice. So here we go. Once again, you get to see it again. And also too, I mean, you get to see a very common mistake. Like I said, I'm sitting here talking and I didn't even look over into my layers and lock. So now I'm gonna pull this down. Once again, select it, right click, arrange, send it to the back, and there it goes. So now we have the back of your garment here. This was on the stitches layer, so we can go up here and delete this. However you want to do it, that's kind of up to you. I'm going to go in and delete that again. Lock my stitches. I'm on my bodice. Show you one more time how to use the Shape Builder tool to do this. Anchor point. I'm going to draw a line here. Shift C, right in the center. Drag it down. You're going to see that happen because there's a fill. No worries. What's the shortcut? Backslash. Now there is no fill. I'm going to grab both of these and select them with the selection tool. Hit Shift M and then click here. And now what I'm going to do is fill this with a light gray, and we have the back of the shirt. So the next thing we need to do now is kind of just add the stitches to the bottom of the hem, and then we need to do the collar around the t-shirt. So here we go. I am going to take this and I'm going to hit direct selection, copy, paste in front. And what that does is it takes the shirt and it gives me the exact same line that I had. And so I just copied it and placed it in front. So I want to show you that again. So this is now, we've been working with the selection tool. Now we're working with the direct selection tool. So as you know, with the selection tool, if you click on one line, it still selects everything. With direct selection, it's a little different. You can select individual anchor points, you can select individual lines. So what I'm going to do is, with my direct selection, I'm going to click on this bottom part of the hem of the shirt, Command C to copy, and Command F to paste in front. It has a fill, because the line previously did that I'm taking it from. So once again, just hit the backslash, get rid of that. I'm gonna use my arrow keys and bring that up. Now what I'm gonna do is select this with the selection tool, copy, paste in front. So I have another one so I can have a double needle and bring that up. Now what I'm gonna do is, there's a little trick over here. Now, yes, I can take my direct selection, hit this anchor point, and I can pull it in to where it's flush with the garment. But if you noticed, it moved on the inside when I did that. So here's a little trick that you can do. I'm going to zoom in so you can see. If anything's hanging over and these two are exactly like this is what you want, this is hanging over, add an anchor point and then delete it. So here we go. Watch this. If you use the plus sign, you'll see that the pin tool pops up. And if you use the negative sign, the pin tool with a minus sign pops up. So I'm going to add an anchor point. I'm going to do this. So hit the plus sign right where it's intersected. See where all of these lines? There we go. I'm going to put an anchor point there. And I'm going to add an anchor point here. Now I'm going to use my direct selection, which is the white arrow, or the letter A is the shortcut. Hit the anchor point now that was on the outside, because remember we just added one. So that now is going to be the end of the line, not this. So hit that, hit delete. Hit this one with your anchor point, hit delete. And then come over to the other side and you get to do it one more time if you thought that was kind of fast. So I'm gonna hit the plus sign on my keyboard. I'm gonna come in here until I see that all of these are intersecting and add an anchor point. Do the same thing here, intersect, add an anchor point. Use my direct selection, which is the white arrow. A is the shortcut to that. Click that, delete. Click that, delete. Then I'm going to zoom out. So now I have the hem the way I would like it. It's selected already, so here's a shortcut. The eyedropper tool isn't just for selecting color. I can also come over with the eyedropper tool, click on that, and eyedrop. Let's zoom in so you can see what I'm doing. Eyedrop these stitches and it turned this one into those stitches. So now select this one. You can do the same thing. Eyedropper tool, shortcut is I. I should have selected both, but there we go. So now we have the bottom hem of the t-shirt as well. So the next thing I'm going to do in the next video is show you how to kind of do the crew neck of the collar. But basically this is it. So on the next video, I'll show you how to do this and then how to actually make the back of the fashion flap. Okay,